MBA Chaiwala is one of the most renowned brands in India's fast food industry today. Started by Praful Billore from a small cart in Ahmedabad, MBA Chaiwala now has multiple outlets across India with a turnover of more than 10 crores, that too just in 5 years of business. With an extraordinary digital presence built on zero marketing budget, MBA Chaiwala's incredible goodwill and brand recognition has helped Prafull sell over 20 franchises in India with prospects of global expansion. Riding on this enormous wave of fame and success, Prafull has also launched multiple other ventures in other categories in other industries, ranging from EdTech to angel investments and more. So the question is, how did MBA Chaiwala become such a big brand in such a short period of time? What were the marketing and sales techniques used by Prafull, a 24-year-old MBA dropout, to scale his business so quickly? And as the experience of startup industry, what are the major lessons that we can learn from Prafull and MBA Chaiwala for our own business? To understand the reasons of MBA Chaiwala's massive success, we first need to understand one of the most important techniques of marketing, commonly known as word of mouth marketing. Let me ask you a question. How many of you guys have used Truecaller to identify unknown calls? Almost everyone, right? Well, have you ever seen any advertisement of Truecaller? No, right? So how did you actually get to know about this amazing application? Well, the answer to this question goes back to our childhood when one of our friends came to us to show this amazing magic trick wherein he asked us to say any random number and with the click of a single button, he told us the name of the person to whom the number belonged. This X factor of Truecaller was so powerful that Truecaller was able to expand globally without having to burn heavily on marketing, and this is exactly what we call as word of mouth marketing. Word of mouth marketing is a marketing technique wherein the brand first creates an X factor in the form of taste, presentation, customer service, or any other thing, and then uses that X factor to create massive impact and awareness. Imagine you go to a panwadi to eat a pan. Now, in order for you to remember that panwadi, he has to offer something so unique that not only it creates an image in your head, but it also forces you to tell about that panwadi to your friends on social media. And that is exactly the case of fire pan or an ice pan. When Prafull started his chai thela back in 2017, he initially had no brand name, no brand image, no branding for his chai joint. People came to him to have a cup of tea, gossip and leave, with no major retention of Prafull or his chai thela. Prafull soon realized that although people enjoyed the taste of his tea, the service and the environment, there was lack of retention and major repetition. As he only sold tea with his brand name, people could not remember his identity, which resulted in lower sales and lesser repetition. However, being a college student with micro profits from his chai thela, he could not afford to spend millions of dollars on marketing. This led to the emergence of MBA Chaiwala, which although was just a name, was so powerful and so memorable that it led to the creation of this major X factor that people started talking about. People were so curious to know about him and his story that more and more people started coming to him, to his chai point, started talking to him about the journey and started to know the exact reason behind this word MBA Chaiwala. Prafull became an overnight sensation with media houses covering his story, colleges inviting him to give speeches and whatnot. Riding on this huge wave of fame, Prafull started making YouTube videos to increase his digital presence, build a community and expand his business. Which brings us to the second part of his success story, the franchisee model. The franchisee model is a business model wherein the brand, due to its incredible goodwill, makes its own customers as business partners. Under the franchisee model, the brand first identifies those customers who are interested in its business and want to own a part of it. Then the brand charges an initial set of fees against which the brand gives the franchisee its machinery, expertise, materials, rights, training and all the other necessary things to run the same business. And finally, the brand signs an agreement with the franchisee for sharing the profits.
So for example, if I, Shaurya, is interested to own an outlet of MBA Chaiwala, I will first pay Prafull an initial setup fees, which is in the case of MBA Chaiwala is between somewhere around 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs. Then Prafull will help me in setting up the business, setting up the outlet in my desired location, and finally, Prafull will ask me to sign an agreement which will state that I'll be managing the outlet, expenses and all the other things, and at the end, all the profits that are generated from the outlet will be shared between me and Prafull. When Prafull started gaining recognition on social media, he realized that a lot of his own customers wanted to personally meet him and do business with him. So, leveraging the power of his digital presence, Prafull started posting more content, started attending more seminars, started selling out franchises to expand MBA Chaiwala across India. For those of you who do not know, some of the largest brands of the world like McDonald's, Subway, Chai Sutta Bar, etc. have used the exact same franchise model to expand its operations globally. However, this franchisee model of business has two major limitations. Number one, in order to sell more and more franchisees, the brand must have an incredible goodwill, a huge community of customers, and a very strong digital presence. Only a known brand will be trusted by people for investment. Well, in our case, luckily, Prafull and his brand MBA Chaiwala had already established a massive digital presence, but there was another problem, which brings us to the last part of our story, supply chain and delegation. When you operate with multiple outlets and on a franchisee model, you have to make sure that each and every outlet serves exactly the same taste, the same product, the same customer experience and the same price. Let's say, if you order a Mac Alu Tikki from a McDonald's in Delhi, and if you order the same burger from a McDonald's in Mumbai, and if by any chance you find the taste of the same burger in the two outlets different, it will create an extremely bad image of the brand and the retention of the customers will decline. Prafull, although was scaling his business with ease due to his massive brand recognition, he had no established supply chain at all. Also, at that point of time, majority of the tasks were being taken care of by Prafull himself, which led to lower effectiveness and efficiency. Prafull soon realized that if he wanted to cope up with his increasing fame and recognition, he will have to do two things. Number one, he will have to establish a proper supply chain, which would mean fixing the raw materials of each and every product, fixing the menu, fixing the suppliers of each and every raw material, and fixing the customer experience across each of his outlet. Number two, as he cannot do each and every task by himself, he will have to build a team and divide the work accordingly so that every task in the business has an established line of command. Well, while scaling his brand, Prafull realized the importance of delegation, and in no time, he established a proper supply chain for his brand MBA Chaiwala, which resulted in him focusing on building his digital presence to sell out more and more franchisees, while his brand was able to run smoothly through the established supply chain and the efforts of his combined team. So, to conclude, the three major lessons from MBA Chaiwala's massive success story that we can implement in our startups are: number one, build a strong digital presence across all the social media platforms in order to drive more and more traffic and sales without burning much cash. Number two, introduce an X factor in our business which will make our product or service go viral through word of mouth marketing. Third, use the power of delegation so that the non-core tasks can be managed by the team while the founders focus on the core tasks of the business. Number fourth, establish a proper supply chain for the business in order to enhance customer satisfaction. MBA Chaiwala's massive success story has already inspired millions of to-be entrepreneurs to start their own venture. With the same goal of imparting knowledge and skills to the next generation entrepreneurs, we at Startup School will see you in another business case study. Make sure to subscribe to Startup School to get all the regular updates of our upcoming videos. Also, if you found the case study of MBA Chaiwala successful and useful, then make sure to like, comment and share the video with your friends and mates. My name is Shaurya Kaushik and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.